I can't remember the last time math made me so excited. The possibilities this opens for us in geometry nodes are endless. What am I talking about? I'm gonna show you how to select every other vertex or every other point in a geometry node setup. What I got here is a basic setup. I got a line, a mesh line. You can see right here. On that line, I'm gonna instance the points. What instances am I gonna use? I have two rigs. If I place that into the instances, you can see by default, if I use pick instances, it actually does the alternating selection already. Bear with me because this isn't always the case. We're gonna build this selection from scratch. Here I'm gonna choose a index, and an index we're gonna have to compare to something. So we have to use a greater than or a compare node, and then we're gonna set that instead of greater than to equal. Feed that index into the A value right there. And the B value is set to 0. We set this to 0 because of the operation we're gonna use next. That is a modulo operation. The modulo operation is a mathematical operation that calculates the remainder. This can be useful in determining divisibility, checking for even and odd numbers, or working with cyclical patterns. In mathematical notion, the modulo operation is often written as A modulo B. For example, if you have 15 modulo 4, I like to think of it like this. In the following scenario, we have 15 people, and we have determined that 4 people hugging is considered a group hug. How many group hugs can we form? That would be 3 group hugs of 12 people total, leaving 3 people by themselves. If the remainder is 0, that will indicate that our selection is even. Enough math talk, let's go right into it. I'm gonna use a math operator, place it in between here, set it to modulo, bring that back. If we're gonna set this to 2, we're gonna measure how many times 2 fits into the index. So the indexes are gonna be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. As you can see right here in the spreadsheet, we're gonna test if it works right now. We're gonna have to plug this result into the instance index. And as you can see, nothing changes. I get that you are not completely sold. So let me prove that this is actually working. I'm gonna select a rotate instances, place it in between here. And if I rotate the instances, you can now see that they are rotating all simultaneously. If I say, for example, get this equal number, say grab the index, place it here, say equal to number, let's pick an arbitrary number, 5. So if the index is equal to number 5, that will rotate. And as you can see, it doesn't rotate anything because we are going from 0 to 4. So I should actually choose 4. And now if I delete the viewer, you can see that it should now rotate the last one. There we go. Bring this selection over right here. I'm gonna reroute it. And if we now place this to 180, they're gonna sit back to back. And I can increase my line to whatever extent I need. So we're gonna double it. And to make it full circle, if I go and select number 4 again, place it into the instance index, you can see that number 4 is now marked red and the rest is all blue. And this indicates that the default is set to every other index in the instances on point node. We can just as well do it with this math equation, because you can also check for example, every 4th number or 8th or 1st, but I guess that will select them all. You get the picture, right? Now, if you enjoyed this, I will also recommend you this video, because you can also further your geometry nodes knowledge here.